Hello, everyone. My name is Orijemie, Emuobosa Akpo. I'm a Nigerian, an archaeologist by training. And I'm here to talk about part of my research in Nigeria. We have been, in the past 3-4 years, working on ancient farming in Nigeria, specifically in Tivland. We know the Tiv people to be one of the ancient farming societies in that part of Africa, West Africa. So we wanted to trace when farming actually started, what kind of crops they cultivated, and why they used such crops in their farming lands and so on. We are particularly intrigued about the Tiv people because they are linguistically classified as Bantu. And as you might know, the Bantu people are supposed to have originated from somewhere between Nigeria and Cameroon and spread to other parts of Africa. So this is like the root of origin of the Bantu people, who are known to be iron workers. But the Tiv people, even though we know that they are linguistically related to the Bantu, this is still a bit controversial because it has not been confirmed if they moved from this area to their present location. According to oral history of the Tiv, they moved from somewhere in Congo and then made a stopover in Cameroon. Finally, they came into Nigeria. Archaeological records does not support this because according to the archaeology of that area, the first peoples there were hunter-gatherers in a rock shelter, popularly known as the Sidra rock shelter. They were there from at about 2,300 till about 1,100. And so recently, we went to our field and see what kind of food resources that these people had, what was their subsistence, what kind of technology did they use, what kind of animals did they consume, and perhaps the transition from hunter-gathering to farming. And surprisingly, when we arrived in this rock shelter, which had hitherto been excavated between 1975 and 1983, with a different focus at that point in time, we found out that there were a lot of lithic materials, particularly materials associated with late Stone Age culture. So in other words, these people were hunter-gatherers. But not only were they hunter-gatherers, they were also using some plant remains. We have found that some of the plant remains included pearl millet, which is popularly known as, botanical name is Penicetum glaucum. This is a major discovery for us. And then we also found the parenchyma cells of tubers. We don't know yet if these tubers are yams or other tubers, but most likely they might belong to yams, the popular Dioscorea species. Not only did we find pearl millet, we also found some other cereals, and we also found beans, which is vigna, and some other plant produce types. Now, the occurrence of the pearl millet is very important because hitherto it had never been found in that part of the country. It had been found in the Nok area as well as the northeastern part of Nigeria. Finding it in Tivland is quite interesting and extends the utilization of this important cereal in prehistoric Nigeria. On the final note, I thank you for listening to us, and I hope you've learned one or two things about ancient farming in Tivland, Nigeria, and West Africa. Thank you very much.